So we have two ACs here, and the natural question to ask is, what's the relationship between these two ACs? So let's say you're Foxconn, and you have five factory sizes to choose from, A, B, C, D, E. So A is the smallest because it's on the SRAC on the left, and E is the largest with the SRAC on the right. B and C are lower than A, and C is lower than B because of the effect of economies of scale. As the firm grows, it faces a lower unit cost. D and E, diseconomies of scale. Because remember I said, imagine that there are many, many different possibilities of the size of the firm. And each of these SRACs just shows one possibility. So as the boss of Foxconn, you can choose what level you want to produce at when you plan. But once you choose the size, you can back out because, you know, in the short run, you can just change your fixed factors. So if you produce very little, you choose the region here. If you produce more and more and more and more, so on. The LRAC is hence these regions because these dictates the cost you will incur if you vary all your factors when you plan. So now imagine if you have an infinite number of choices, which is a more accurate reflection of real life because it can pretty much expand in very small increments, however infinitely many options you have, then your choices will lie along the edges of these SRACs, and the edges of this SRAC forms your LRAC.